Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon. Is this on? Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It is I once again, Lord Ibo Risi Hards, and I'm just chilling here in one of our little comfortable courtyards. And you're watching IZ Corp Exchange Television. What we're talking about right now is Economics Corner. And on IZ Corp Exchange Television. To get straight to the point, we saw the NASDAQ, which is one of my favorite indexes, not only as a bellwether, but I like to trade it once and again. You know, I trade the E-mini. And we saw the Dow Jones reaching, this is U.S. economy, by the way. So we're really doing, it's really, the economics corner is more like a finance of what the broad-based finance in the U.S. economy is about. It's a research company on that. A member of the IZ Corp Exchange of Good Standings Economics Corner. You can subscribe to the newsletters as well. So we were studying, we're just following the broad markets, the in trade data, the cash markets, the trading markets of the U.S. economy today. And we saw for the past two sessions, being what it was today, July 27th, Friday, 6 p.m., we saw I just got a report come through my desk, through one of my trade desks, that the Twitter was down pretty big, and we were buying Twitter at $30-something, and now it's back down. So we saw that Twitter, Google was down, tech stocks are taking a hit. But the important thing was we liked the Dow. You know, we were looking at the Dow to hit that 25.5 mark, and then we were thinking volatility would kick in, and more investors will come into the market, and then the people that rode up the last 800 points would come down, because you would see the R2 resistance point get tested again, because so many traders are going to come in, like myself included. You know, we have a trade group and we have other trade groups, and people are saying when it hits the 25.5, they're going to buy. So you might say, okay, I'm going to buy some too. But at the same time, I'm going to take most of my positions off. So we, you know, try to catch the 1,000 points back down, because it looks like we're just, you know, you're just floating in a range there until we probably see some interest rates. We'll wait till the next FOMC meeting, and what the new administration is really going to be up to. And then, you know, there's a big election this year. And also in the U.S. economy, we're still waiting for a stimulus that was supposedly been approved. And I thought it would be out by summertime, and then that would kick in before the break. So we'll see what happens before the U.S. leaders take a break, and then we'll come back. Then there should be a next meeting, an FOMC meeting, or a Fed speak should be coming up, and to see where they're going. But at the same time, there'll be an election going on. And we still haven't seen the stimulus. So we're just looking at the markets today. And I haven't been following the news actually to see what's going on in the social media space. But the question, our forum on our blog is, in the social media space, it's looking like it's a tech company. People are saying social media is tech. Tech is social media. Now the government's going to regulate online businesses for taxes. At the same time, whatever's going on in Europe and Africa with Facebook and social media, because, you know, we don't live under the same guidelines, you know what I'm saying? Freedom of speech isn't, you know, in the United States of America, you're blessed with a lot of things that people outside of the gate would say, those are amenities. You know, you can go online and make fun of your local politician, or your state politician, or your government house politician, and it's all fair game. You know, everything is fair game in the U.S. You can make fun of anybody. You can talk and say what you want to say about anybody. There's rules and laws that says, well, you can't say it's not true, and you can get into that in court, you know, and say, well, you know, I've been character assassined or something like that. But you know, that's like one of those things. When you get to that bridge, you cross to that when you get to the bridge. But if somebody's on you, or if you're hot and you have people coming after you, they're gonna come after you regardless. You know, whether you're doing good, whether you're doing bad. If you just fall into that, or you just get into that, there's nothing anybody can do about it. Overseas, you know, we're like emerging. The markets are emerging with the social media, and they're picking up on a lot of our stuff, culture, and we're picking up on their culture, which is like Flintstone-ish compared to how we operate on U.S. mainland. You know, like I said, everything goes, but over there, it's not that kind of party. And I don't think the government officials in China, even in Europe, or even especially in the African spaces, are really into all of this. You know, you just get out there and express yourself, and it's okay. So they probably latching on a lot of regulations and speaking to these people and be like, look, you know, I know you're doing a lot of business, but we're gonna start cutting you back, because we don't want this Western stuff. We don't do freedom of speech in China. You know, we don't do that over here. And you know, you got a lot of, you know, it's just a lot of stuff, religion and all that. So follow the Economics Corner. We were just looking at the thing. And then the other thing is the social media space. You know, is it a tech company? Is it social media? That's confusing a lot of investors. You know, people are looking at it as social media. Now you're coming in, you're saying, well, this is they're not social media, they're tech. So what happens is now my investment mentality or my mantra changes, because if it's social media and they're blocking it out over there, I might just try to wait for it to pass. But if you're a tech company and you're getting hit like that, you know, it's just a different way of looking at an investment. And these things used to be really cheap, and they're very young, and I think they're still cheap. Twitter at $45 or $40 is dirt cheap, dirt cheap. Facebook at $200 is really cheap. So, you know, you're down today. I haven't even looked and seen where it is today. But, you know, Google is the thing to watch. It's really exciting. You know, Google is doing fascinating things on this planet, and Amazon as well. So the social media scene, now you would look and say, well, what is Google? Social media or a tech company? So these are things that, you know, the market, the broad market, has to figure out and filter itself. My name is Lord Iborisi Hodge. You're watching IZ Corp Exchange Television, and this is an Economics Corner report. Thank you and have a great day.